From WREL News and the Capital Broadcasting Podcast Network, this is your Coronavirus North Carolina News Brief for Thursday, April 23rd, 2020. I'm Cliff Baumgartner. Here's the latest from WREL.com. Today, Governor Roy Cooper spelled out a three-phase, data-driven plan to lift the restrictions of his stay-at-home order and gradually reopen businesses statewide during the ongoing coronavirus pandemic. But none of those actions will occur before May 8th, as Cooper tacked a week onto his order, which has been in place since March 30th and was scheduled to expire next week. The stay-at-home order will remain in place in the first phase of the reopening plan, but more retailers will be able to open if they practice social distancing guidelines for protecting customers and screen employees' health daily. Parks will also be allowed to open, but people will be asked to cover their faces in public. After a few weeks, the stay-at-home order will be lifted to allow larger gatherings and more business activity. After a few more weeks, the final phase calls for larger caps on mass gatherings. If data shows a resurgence in coronavirus cases at any point, Cooper said the state might need to step back a phase. In all, the governor stressed North Carolina would not return to pre-coronavirus norms anytime soon, but said the state would recover and prosper once more.
If we keep protecting ourselves and go back to work and play carefully, we can rebuild the damage that this virus has done to our state. North Carolinians are tough. And we will beat this virus.
The State Board of Education has approved a grading system for the spring semester interrupted by the coronavirus pandemic, an issue that's been at the front of many parents' minds as their students grapple with the challenges of remote learning. Officials from the Department of Public Instruction said the spring 2020 policy is, quote, as flexible as possible, taking into account that students in different areas have differing access to technology, internet connections, and educational support, and the space and time to focus on their studies while isolated with their families. You can find a full breakdown of the new grading practices and how they're going to be implemented on WREL.com. Today, lawmakers in the North Carolina House backed a bill with more than $600 million in it for COVID-19 research, medical care, hospital bailouts, and a slew of other programs. A key budget writer called it Phase 1. The North Carolina Healthcare Association says hospitals around the state are out about $1 billion a month because of the elimination of profitable, non-essential procedures and spending on COVID-19 preparations. The House Working Group, laying out priorities ahead of next week's legislative session, also approved a bill that details long-term plans for a new state stockpile of personal protective equipment, the PPE considered so crucial to protect hospital and other frontline workers from the new coronavirus. The bills include funding for rural hospitals and a temporary Medicaid boost, if the federal government signs off on it, to cover COVID-19 treatment costs for people up to 200% of the federal poverty level. That's an annual income of about $50,200 for a family of four. The General Assembly returns to session next Tuesday. In the meantime, the House of Representatives has had working groups preparing legislation. Those bills will also need approval from the state Senate, which hasn't yet held public committee meetings, and Governor Roy Cooper. But word is, so far, all the branches are cooperating. From WRAL TechWire, with unemployment claims now nearing 720,000, North Carolina ranks as the fifth hardest state for job losses since the COVID-19 crisis accelerated across the country in March. A new study from financial information site WalletHub ranks North Carolina, the nation's ninth largest state in terms of population, and other states based on the percentage growth in claims from a year ago. North Carolina's is more than 3,800%. Since January, the state is the fourth biggest hit for losses. More than 14,000 North Carolinians applied for jobless benefits on April 22nd, according to the State Department of Employment Services. North Carolina was the seventh most affected state last week. Of those, some 617,000 are attributed to the pandemic. The news comes as another 4 million Americans sought unemployment benefits over the last week, pushing the total to more than 26 million and effectively wiping out all new job increases since the end of the Great Recession in 2008 and 2009. This has been your Coronavirus North Carolina News Brief for Thursday, April 23rd, 2020. As always, if you like the information and resources you're getting from this show, let us know. Leave a rating and review on whatever podcast app you use. And while you're there, be sure to subscribe. Thanks for listening.